How and when did you start shooting?
Well, that's a big answer. when officially it was in 1990, my first big competition in the Air Force. And my first one was, I was kid, I don't know, I was 15, 16, but just locally for fun. Then in the Air Force in 86, I was trying because I heard about it in my unit. Then in 97, I did it again. And then I stopped for two or three years because I was in sergeant's course. Then I really started in 1990 in the Air Force. Then I was on the Federation on 92.
Yeah. So I remember from our conversation that you basically told me you started when you were around 35.
No, that was my first Olympic Games in 2000.
Ah, okay.
I did start with 25, yeah. It was in 1990.
And what made you decide to train and compete more seriously? What was your progression like?
Yeah, because in this year, 1991, I was in the Air Force competition, and I was very good with 9mm. And I was also in the national military game shooting. And then I realized I had some capacity for the shooting because I didn't know. That's why in 92 I was in the local club and I said, well, I like to shoot. I have a pistol from the Air Force. I would like to try here in your club. And that's it, because I was trying in the Air Force first.
And what are you most proud of in your shooting career or in your shooting in general?
Well, all the medals, of course.
Yeah, it's good.
Yeah, it's good. The medals, and like you can see in behind me, the accreditation cards, all of these things from the shooting, because that's traveling, that's making new friends, that's making new places, and that's most important after the medals.
What advice has had the biggest impact in your shooting, and who gave it?
Well, I think it's somebody in 93 or 94 told me, you must try free pistol. Free pistol is what makes you go to the Olympics. And I, what? What is that free pistol? You must try free pistol. And I still remember it. I think it's the most important advice, because it changed everything. I was only on 9mm and center fire. And standard pistol, and then I changed it to air pistol and free pistol, and then it makes all the difference. And it was said by somebody from the Federation. I think he was another shooter. He was a little bit older than me, and I think he was in the Federation in some position. I don't remember what he was doing over there then.
And what did you spend a lot of effort on and later discover that wasn't so important for your shooting?
No, everything was important for shooting. Maybe we are changing our opinions every year or every 2 years. I think something else is important, but everything is important.
And then how do you train and how often do you train? What is a typical training day like for you?
My typical training is just go to the shooting range and shoot. That's it. I don't have different exercises or physical exercises for the shooting. And my normal training is just go and shoot without electronic targets. Without SCAT or any kind of these electronic devices. Just shoot real bullets or real pellets, and that's the most important for me. Good. And of course, before the big competitions, I trained a lot.
Because you told me you trained without a coach.
Yeah. I don't have a coach. I never had a coach because I live far away from Lisbon. The coach is over there. The national coach is over there. So I do it at my shooting range at my house, and or in the, my old club, my first club in Nieria, but never did ever a real coach. I had some books, somebody was trying to teach me some things, but I was just filtering the best to and what was more important for me.
How do you stay motivated in training and in competition?
In competition is easy. We always are motivated to get a medal. And for our training, that's difficult. But we must think that it's an important competition. We must go there and do our best, or our nationals competition. And well, it's different from every from a person to another person. It's totally different. For me, it's just an hobby. I had another job. My main job, I was military. So this was an hobby that I was just doing for fun.
And what do you do before a match or before a training to get into the right mind space?
Yeah, maybe I'm quieter 2 days before, and I don't speak more. I be careful with something I could get hurt, and I don't want to be hurt on a hand, on an arm. So normally I'm more quiet before the competitions.
How do you manage nervousness through a competition?
We can't. We just live with it. Nowadays, it's so many competitions. I just don't feel nervous, like be shaking or these kind of things. But in the beginning, it was difficult, but we must live with it. And in the beginning, it was centerfire, standard pistol, 9mm, and then it's different to be nervous with these weapons, because the target is a little bigger. It's not 50 meters on air pistol. So it was easy for me, because also 10 was bigger.
Yeah, that counts.
Yeah.
Do you have any special inner talk when you're competing that you think that you tell yourself, or
no? No. I just do the technical things, what I have to do to have a good shot, trigger, finger, aiming sights, and that's it.
Yes. And of all your shooting technique, which aspect do you think has brought the biggest improvement to you?
I can speak about shoes, but then, well, shoes are not very important. Just to find the right grip for my hand, it's very important. Then it's if we free pistol, we must control the wind. Everything is different from shooting range to shooting range, because if I am in a air pistol competition with a guy next to me that's always moving, and I'm very nervous, it extracts me. So I must change my shooting to avoid looking at him and be distracted also. So it depends on the competitions.
And do you think that this adaptability can be trained? Is there any way to train so that you get used to adapt to different conditions, or just compete?
Just compete and a lot of experience. The most international competitions, the easier is for us to shoot, because experience is all, it's everything, I think.
And when you're at the shooting range, you're ready to shoot, what is your shot process like? What does a shot in your mind or in your body look like?
Yeah, I must think about the focusing the target, raise the arm, then focusing the settings, then the pressure of the grip, pressure of the finger, and the follow through. And the most important of these things is to do everything the same sequence, 60 shots. If I'm thinking something else, easily it's a 9 or 8. So it's very important to keep focus on the trigger and the sights every shot.
And to get this focus, is there anything in particular that you can use or you can train, or this is just a question of will, of motivation, like I'm going to be focused and I'm focused?
Yeah, it's a will. You must do it, otherwise you don't have the results. That's it.
Is there any tool or equipment you cannot live without?
Most important is my box with the guns, with the right guns inside. I never have a mistake like that, to go to a shooting range with different guns, but then inside the box, it's everything. I have the screwdriver, I have the all the tools to the shooting, the glasses, the sometimes the shoes. So if I, one or two days before the competition, I put everything inside the box, then the box is filled with everything I need.
And I was surprised to see that you have a different, for air pistol, you have a different match gun and a second gun, just in case the other one breaks.
No, that happens last time you saw me, because my second gun, my first gun was broken.
Okay.
And I was shooting with my second gun. So the other one you saw as a replacement was my third one. It was a different kind, because my first one was on repairing. But now it's everything okay. My two guns are the same.
Okay. Is there any question you would have liked? Is there any question you would have liked me to ask and I didn't?
I don't know. Maybe what can you say to young shooters to keep shooting?
What can you say to young shooters to keep shooting? You have?
Yeah, I think the young shooters mostly are distracted with, after they find they are good shooters, then they are distracted with education or family problems, or they have a girlfriend or a wife. And it happens a lot of times that in these moments of life, they go out of shooting. So I would like to say, no matter what happens, just shoot for 1 year or two, or stop for 1 year and shoot only one or two times, and always keep shooting, because if you like to shoot, the wheel will come again.
Thanks a lot. Thanks a lot, Joao. It's been a great interview.
Thank you.